Dad, I need some water.
Did you see the other circle photos?
Drop off a message, they would coil it up, it's kind of like a paper airplane in a way, with some kind of weight on there, and aim it off towards the eight.
The remaining two members of the freight train crew, the brakemen, were assigned several tasks. In the early years of steam, trains used a manual braking system. Brakemen climbed onto the roof of each car and turned its wheel brake by hand. This hazardous task ended in the 1870s with the invention of the Westinghouse automatic air
Yes.
Here, stand up there on that deck and let me get a picture.
Three. Run. Thank you.
a new little golden book total.
Plus the cost of my facility.
As time progressed, we seem to be
Wilmington before the station got closed.
Oh, this is the station.
Yep.
Is that it?
Yep, we're in the station right now.
Where is it at on here?
All this is right where we just passed by.
Is that the train yard up there?
That's the train shed. It's almost like Spencer.
Where is it at?
It would have been just over down here, but it's got torn down.
Yeah.
Watch, another train's gonna come back up in a minute. This is how Myrtle Beach operated their trains. Watch, island trees. Watch, island trees. This is how Myrtle Beach operated their trains.
Oh, it comes out of the tree.
Now arriving on track 1, train number 17 from Rocky Mountain and Norfolk with connecting service from New York, Washington, and Richmond. And back from the track.
Does that one just go back and run back into where the trees are?
Yeah, if you press this again, it'll send back the other one.
Train number 8 departing on track number 1 from Rocky Mountain, Richmond, Norfolk, Washington, and New York.
It becomes a little drag.
Where were the scouts at? Do you remember?
Oh, no. So where's the museum at on this?
This is not...
Right there. Is that what
this isn't really a scale version of...
Yeah, but I mean, is that it right there?
I guess so. That's what the roundhouse would look like.
Lucas.
Here's a little streetcar thing. That's how Myrtle Beach operated their trains.
That's the music.
Yep.
So in this picture, it's right here.
Yep. Wilmington used to have like street cars. I guess they took them out. What is?
It's still a roundabout thing.
What?
Is that roundabout thing still there?
No. Shunting cars. It's moving some cars.
So this building used to be even longer.
Yep. They took out the tracks on that built, you know where that... Took it out. They didn't need this place anymore.
They built something else there.
Yeah, you know where the parking garage is over there? That's where the tracks used to go.
Stand back from the track.
Thank you.
taken.
Inside the Atlantic Coastline 250, 460, 10-wheeler type locomotive built by Baldwin in 1911, I believe. Here's the outside. It's got a round top single chime. Looks like a 12-inch hooter, but of course it's not connected. It's just there for show. Bell's connected though. Some various valves and stuff. Here's the fireman's side. I gotta sit down here. Firebox. Fireman will be the one ringing the bell, which I'll put it up to for right now. Just gonna grab the rope. Here we go. Firebox door. And here's the engineer's side. Regulator right here, which is kind of what puts it in forward or reverse throttle, or the regulator, whatever it's called. You can call it whatever. This is like the throttle anyways. Pull it back and release the steam. This is the brake. I think maybe it's something else, I don't know. I think this would have been a brake, as you can see it's been taken out. And the whistle would have been through this hole right here. As you can tell, they don't have the whistle connected, so. So the tender. Here's the tender. It's a coal burner. If it was still in service, it would probably likely be an oil burner. As far as I know, the 250 came from Tampa. And it was cosmetically restored. It's been like this ever since. It's already starting to collect rust though. Some various valves and stuff. These three are valves to tell you if you didn't know what the water level is, because if there's a water sight glass in here, you can release these things and it will blow it out steam, and it'll tell you how much steam it or water it's got. There's some various valves up there. Like the pressure valve. Some lights are here and whatever this is. I believe this valve goes to what would have been the dynamo, which is what powered the electricity on the locomotive. I know I don't remember too well, but got this random thing right here. Don't know what it is. I think this is what tells you how much oil it has. If it was an oil burner, but taking your view of the locomotive. Shut off valves and stuff. Got a semaphore signal outside. One of these things is release the brakes, put this in like forward, and then move the throttle until the throttle's welded together or rusted together.